This is how you can retouch your skin and remove blemishes in Davinci Resolve for free. Do you ever wonder that when editing a photo, you can retouch your skin and remove pimples or any blemishes pretty easily? But for video, it's another story. Because it's not a still pictures anymore, and the subject's face is moving, right? So are there any tools that can retouch your skin for your video? I'll tell you what, yes it is. In DaVinci Resolve, there's an effect that specifically tracks your face and refines all the blemishes for you. It's called face refinement. And if you combine it with other free tools and some techniques that I'm gonna show you in a second, you pretty much get a video version of Photoshop. So let's open DaVinci Resolve. So right here, I have prepared my own footage. All I did is just a little bit of exposure, balance, and saturation. So first of all, you would need to go into the effects tab and search for the face refinement. Then drag that effect into one of the nodes, and it will tell you to analyze the footage. So you just click this analyze button and wait until it's done analyzing. Then you can uncheck this show overlay to see the whole pictures. Then you can see that there are a lot of retouching elements. For example, eye retouching, I can brighten up my eye to somewhere like that. Not much, because if it's too much, so keep it subtle. And you can sharpen in your eyes a little bit, not too much. Then the eye lights is pretty much brighten up area around your eyes. Like that. Then the eye bag removal. We're not gonna go that far, so keep it subtle as you can so that it's not creating some artifacts. Somewhere like that. And there are some pimples on my forehead. I'll go into the forehead retouching and smooth it up. Something like that. Not too much. You can also retouch your lip. For example, I'll increase the saturation, or you can change the hue. They also have this blush retouching where you can increase the saturation of your blush, but I won't do that. So like most of the time, these two things are usually what I did. Like I would not do more than that. There's another way to remove blemishes. Let's say if there are some pimples that are really big and hard to remove, you can use a window to remove that. So for example, I'll create a circle window, resize it down so that it just only covers that pimples. I'll track that window. Then you head into the node sizing, which is this one right here, and check this key lock. Then you can tilt or pan your window to replace that pimples with other part of your skin. Right here. See how clean this is? Let's say we have another one. Right here, right? We create a parallel window and resize the window to just cover that pimples. And then track that. And then again, go into the node sizing and check this key lock. Adjust your pan and tilt. Let's say the skin that you replace is a little bit brighter and it's not that clean. You can also go into the primary tab and reduce the offset down. Another technique is you use a glow effects. Then you can add a window to just affect your face. Reduce the saturation down. Then the gain down. Like that. You can also use a noise reduction to smooth your skin by going to the noise reduction tab right here and add this spatial noise reduction to the point where you feel it's not too much. Then you can use a power window to just make it affect your face and track it. Then obviously when you do all this retouching skin, you will lose a bunch of texture on your face. You would want to add that back. And the tools that I use most of the time is texture pop. Then drag it into your node. And I'll change the color mode to Luma and Chroma. And the operating mode to Advanced. And I'll change only the tiny and fine slider to where it's add that texture back a bit. Like that. You can also add mid-tone detail to increase more texture to your skin. Most of the time I'll just leave it around 10 to 20. So if we turn off all the adjustment that we just did, this is before and after. Before, after. That's it for today. Hope this helped. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next video. Happy grading. Bye.